Hi, I'm Artifacts of Mars, and I want to do something a little different today. I don't have any great examples of the turtle stones, but I am going to show a couple of them. I'm not at Tomokinesis. I'm at Hemlock Lake Park, the northern end of Hemlock Lake, and at the end of Hemlock Lake, there are these big, tall pillars. At the end of the park, there's these big, tall pillars. And they have a couple of examples of the turtle stones. Turtle stones are indigenous to this area. They actually come from the Tomokinesis, right in that area. It's the only place in the world where they come from. And they're a mystery. So sit back and relax. In part two, it's all going to be the same video, but in part two, we're going to discuss a couple other things. Because a lot of the stuff shouldn't even exist here if the official record is correct. But it does. So go grab a cup of coffee and relax and enjoy. I gotta grab my camera, so... Alrighty. You see that? That's an example of the turtle stones. Now, science doesn't have any answers as to how the turtle stones were created. I wish I had better samples than this. I'm not in Canisius. Canisius is a little too far for today. But we're going to look over this pillar. Now, 50,000 years ago or such, supposedly, if you believe the official narrative, this area was under, what, a couple miles of ice? And the Finger Lakes, Hemlock is one of the Finger Lakes, were carved out by the retreating glaciers. Now, everything you're seeing here, these are all natural rocks. And this is a monument, roots of the armies of General John Sullivan and General James Clinton, 1779, an expedition against the hostile Indian nations, which got screwed, which checked the aggressions of the English and Indians on the frontiers of New York and Pennsylvania, extending westward to the Dominion of the United States. Erected by State of New York, 1929, I believe it says. These are all natural rocks. And turtle stones are quite real. They're not an April Fool's joke. They only come from this one area. Science doesn't have any answers as to how they could possibly exist. Basically, they resemble the back of a turtle, the shell of a turtle, and that's why they get their name. There are probably much better examples of the turtle stones on Canisius. I'm not going down there. I don't intend to spend a lot of time doing this. I want to goof off on the computer. You get the point. Let's go over and take a look at other pillars and see what we have. Now, sharp-eyed people will notice that you have granite in this pillar, and that should tell you something. I'll get to that. That's part two. Granite's a very common stone here in New York State. So I'm going to take a look at this other pillar. And then what I'm gonna do, I don't think there are any more turtle stones than these. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna put this on hold, and we'll go over to, what's the western shore of Hemlock Lake. That's way beyond this park. I'm gonna get in my car, go over there, and we're gonna go take a little walk along the shoreline and see what we find. And while we're doing that, we're going to have a little discussion about granite and a couple other things. Stand by. Okay. This is gonna be a problem. We've had a lot of rain lately. And precipitation, we had the one big snowstorm. So, I'm not going to be able to do a lot with the rocks, unfortunately, because most of the shoreline is underwater. This is Hemlock Lake. This is the western edge of it. I just don't know. I don't have a lot of rocks to show you. So, here's what I'm going to do instead. We have a little discussion about granite. Now, what is granite? It's a common stone around here, right? What type of stone is granite? Granite is what's known as an igneous rock. Now, there are two types of igneous rocks. We're going to take a look in this pool and see if we might catch some polywogs. There are two types of igneous rocks. One type is caused by impacts, and we're not going to deal with that now. The other is caused by volcanic activity. What's wrong with this picture? Well, if you make the connection, there's a big problem. There's no volcanic craters or anything here in New York State. Yet, igneous rocks like granite, like I showed you, are common rocks. You see the inherent problem there? It's a major conflict, actually. We'll walk along here and see if we find anything interesting. That's one thing that geologists probably don't want to talk about. They probably don't like talking about the fact that there is granite and other igneous rocks here in New York State, because it creates a little conflict in their little world. They tell us this state is stable. Ah, okay. I'm not going to have any luck along the shoreline, but maybe if we move a little closer to the road and keep a look for polywogs or anything interesting in the water here, we'll head towards the road. Most of these are, most of these stones you're seeing are sedimentary. Now, in the stones, you can see zillions of fossils if you want looking. Seashells and that type of thing. Geologists do admit that this area was underwater at one time, under sea. Yet, if you look up the official record, they don't exactly say when. Here's a mixed bag. Mostly sedimentary rock. An example of a sedimentary rock would be like sandstone. That's that one that you pick up and kind of crumbles in your hand. I wanted to do the seashore walk, but that's not going to happen. A lot of wind out today, not an especially inviting day at all. There's still some fishermen out because the Finger Lakes, the season begins on the 1st, trout season does, 1st of April. These are mostly sedimentary rocks here. So, nothing really interesting, although maybe I can find some fossils. Looks like there might be a few. Okay. Now, there's other mysteries in this state. You don't really want to look at my ugly mug, do you? So, we're going to walk along. There are other mysteries in the state, besides the fact that we have igneous rocks and no volcanic activity. We have these things called salt mines. Now, what are the salt mines? Well, obviously, they mine salt, and they keep our roads salted and rust out all the cars. But how did that salt get there? We're talking unbelievable quantities of it, and it's underground. Once again, I don't think science has any answers. These rocks weren't put here naturally. These are quarried, I believe. Might be able to pick up some fossils. So, we have all that salt underground. Sorry, I keep getting off track. We have all that salt underground, and nobody knows how it got there. Was it because we had oceans? I don't know. See, there's a lot of little mysteries like that that science has not solved. They don't seem to be terribly interested in solving them either. Because it doesn't fit. My point here is it doesn't fit into their worldviews. Like the turtle stones. They don't fit into their worldview. So, they don't make a big deal of it, they kind of keep quiet about it. You can look the turtle stones up, you won't find a lot of information on it. Now, here's a natural rock, and I don't think it was quarried. I would have preferred to show the rocks that are along the shoreline, but we had some small ones, and right in this area. You know, zoom in on that. That's a natural. If you're looking at, you're seeing granite. This pink one down here, that's granite. That is an igneous rock that was formed by volcanic activity. The problem is there aren't any volcanoes here. So no one really knows. And science doesn't talk about this very much. Because like I said, it doesn't fit into their worldview. Their worldview is that the solar system came together by accident, formed from gas and clouds and whatnot. Earth came into being, then there's all this turmoil, and then some little beastie came together by accident. That beastie began multiplying, that beastie became a eukaryote, and then it became a, you know, plankton, and became a fish, and became this, and became that, so on and so forth. That's the official record, but the truth is much more complex. I should have worn gloves. My hands are getting cold. So I'm going to wrap this. But I think I made my point. Between salt mines and the turtle stones and igneous rocks that are present here in western New York, we have a lot of anomalies. When I was a kid, I didn't question anything. But as an adult, seeing how there's a general dishonesty among scientists, almost rivaling that of politicians, I've begun to question and I've begun to wonder. I just don't know. You know, if we'll ever get any decent answers out of our politicians, I don't know. Of course, if you just want to be a beach bum and sit there and watch the waves roll in, more power to you. Enjoy. But as for me, I'm going to do an occasional video. Next one I want to do is nature's acrobats. If I get a decent day when the squirrels are going. I've not seen any squirrels running around. I have a point to make, as always, of course. For now, I'm going to sign off and head back where I came from. This is Artifacts of Mars. I appreciate you watching my video. Hopefully YouTube won't demonetize it, although I am slamming science a little bit. Thanks for watching. Have a good day.